That was a good sound.
It was a good choice of key as well.
And it's a B flat on a Monday morning. God. Like, I make it as difficult for myself from the beginning of the day, or the beginning of the week.
Yeah,
so I know it, if it gets worse during the week, at least we got a B flat
out on Monday morning.
And a blues riff. At least we can start with
that. Well, welcome back to Andertons TV. We're looking at some pedals today from another universe, apparently, according to their website. But before we start, please like and subscribe to this channel, because we're giving free stuff away. Look at what we're giving away. I think when we hit 850,000 subscribers, which should be soon at the rate that you guys are subscribing, we're giving this Victory V4 thing away.
Yeah, yeah.
And ultimately, though, we're on a journey to the big one. When we get to a million, one of the clones will be yours.
So you're saying we're giving free stuff away, but we're giving stuff away, but it's not really free because
it's free for them. If you win it. Cost me a lot of money.
Right,
so that's that one. Now, we use timestamps in these videos. They're super, super handy in a video like this, because if you only want to hear about this pedal and you can't be bothered to sit through all the other ones, then check the timestamps below, and yes, you'll be able to see where each of these is demonstrated.
And the best timestamp of all of them is the little one that it's a little triangle like that, and it's got a little thing on the front. It's next to the play button. You skip that in your next video. Because it's so bored already. Watching this. Oh, that's the best timestamp.
Brutal.
That's a brutal timestamp.
It is. But. And finally, somebody get pizza and more coffee. And maybe you want to buy a sweatshirt as modelled by our beautiful in-house Danish modelling team. Or a beanie or a t-shirt or a hoodie
indeed.
Yes, Sarah Beanie. Right, today's video is about an American pedal company called Analog Alien. If you're into funny marketing stories about people coming from another galaxy, go and read the About Us page on the Analog Alien website. But for now, we're just going to dive straight in with the Double Classic. This is a signature pedal for the guitar icon, legend, total hero, Joe Walsh.
Yeah.
And it's basically a compressor and an overdrive pedal in one box.
That's a good combination.
Why wouldn't you? I like the fact that you've got a pre and post switch here for where you want the compressor to be in the chain, so you can use it almost like a boost to your overdrive or something that just kind of fattens and tightens at the same time.
Can be used separately as well.
Absolutely. Yeah, yeah. So let's start with our clean sound with Pete's Les Pauls.
Straight into DP40, everything on 12 o'clock.
I'm trying to think if I ever saw Joe Walsh playing anything other than a Les Paul, or in more recent years, a Paul Reed Smith.
Yeah, a Les Paul Reed Smith.
Right, so that's our clean sound. This is dead easy to whiz through. And actually, there's an element the simplicity of the knobs for getting gain and compression out of this are actually quite refreshing, to be honest with you. So here isn't...
It kind of pushes the amp into a bit of a... this is overdrive, that's why it is, does that. You know what? I really like that tone.
I think
it's great, man. I think... It's like...
It's the purple.
It's not like a tube scream at all. And no. It's not like a... That's a nice and fat kind of... What is it? Is the bass done anything or...?
You got bass, treble, gain, and output.
Yeah. Right. And that gain is... Nice overdrive. Ooh. play some new licks, Pete?
That is nice. So, okay, now we'll do the compressor separately, and then we'll combine.
Well, that is compressing. That's a nice compressor, it's not too overpowering. Yeah. Simplicity of it.
Me too.
That you just set somewhere and it just sounds good.
It's easy
to
get a nice sound out of this, isn't it?
Oh, and I love
the
colour.
So now I'm going to show you the compressor before the gain circuit and then after the gain circuit using this pre and post switch.
So what we hear pre? It gets that sort of that.
If we switch it to post now, it's not increasing the amount of gain, it's kind of controlling the total sort of dynamic output.
And it's too, then it becomes too compressed, but...
It talks about, in the manual, it being based on the kind of kit that Joe Walsh would have had in the Cloud 9 studios. And I often think with compression on guitar players would normally, or at least in my opinion, you'd have a compressor in front of your amplifier or in front of the gain to use as a sort of a bit of a boost, a fattening thing. But in the studio, the compression would be applied sort of at the end of everything to just get a sense of like consistent sort of range. Yeah. And I guess that's the idea, is if you're in the studio, maybe you're using it in post mode. If you're playing live, maybe
What's the compressor based on? Does it say anything what it's based on? Like the Overdrive?
It just says the hardware that he would have had in the studio.
Okay, so it'd be like an Everything 76 or an L2.
I would imagine his studio's probably got all the good stuff.
Yeah, like. And that's what people do, isn't it? You record the thing up and sometimes it goes in the front as well. It depends on, whatever.
What's your favourite Eagles song?
Hotel California. Best solo in the world, isn't it?
Probably. Although wasn't that...
I just listened to it and I go to there and then I'll give up. Even though I should just sit down and... We should do a video on learning it, me and you, together.
Who was the... Wasn't it Don Felder?
Take It Easy is great as well.
Take It Easy is probably my favourite. But only purely and simply because, you know, some songs get played so much that they become almost a parody of themselves or whatever like that.
Yeah.
I almost kind of feel that's what happened with... Exactly. Oh. Anyway, so... there you go.
That great, sounds great, man.
Great start. Great start.
Yeah, I can only go downhill from here.
Yeah, absolutely. I did want to show you, I mean, some of the pedals, the smaller ones, just seem to come in cardboard boxes. Some of them come in these rather fetching, I guess you'd normally, this is like a wine cooler, isn't it? Or a beer cooler type thing.
It's funny what's in here as well. There was something extra in this one.
That's interesting.
Brutal. Yeah, look, it's got this stuff in. You can have it. It's like a lunch.
Yeah, absolutely. Keep your pedal cool. And then one of them even comes in this rather fetching sort of presentation wooden. What have we got in here with other goodies? Oh. Stickers, you card, a thank you, dear fellow alien. Thank you. We've got some
chili.
Is it chili sauce? It says hot sauce.
Yeah.
It is Alien Twister hot sauce. Ow! And then, of course, a pedal. You'd like to think that after all that, there was at least a pedal in there.
So we'll play.
We don't have an Alien Twister out at the moment, right? So let's just pop this out and.
Yeah.
Ooh, cool colour. Ooh! They've all got these nice kind of stick-on raised badges, which I think looks sweet. Actually, I say we're going to try them all today. We're not going to try them all because there is at least one bass pedal here that we'll have to get our bass experts.
And this one, I think, will give a miss as well.
That is some serious bit of studio kit there, isn't it? You've got
Balanced output, you got, you know.
It's an A-B switcher, a DI box, with a send and a buffer all in one. Yeah. Oh, and a loop as well. Holy moly. That's called the EPI, effects pedal interface. Anyway.
Let's move on.
I might as well just do this one that I've taken out of the box now, because it's called the Fuzz Bubble 45.
Dialed.
So the Fuzz Bubble 45, I'm reading off my phone here. It's inspired by the epic guitar tones of bands like The Beatles, The Rolling Stones, The Who, and Jimi Hendrix. Just four of those kind of, you've probably never heard of them, so, you know, stay tuned.
And if you haven't, then shame on you.
So it's two kinds of pedal in one. We've got an on-off switch here, and then we toggle between the overdrive side and the fuzz side. And I've never seen this done before, but well played, analog alien. There must be we'll see what this does here, but there's some sort of tone control here that goes between the year 1967 1977. So you can literally, you could find almost the hour that you wanted within that
when George Harrison was really high on something, and it was in 1964 at 4.
So here's without.
September 7th. So that's just a little. Bits in, so we don't get copyright strikes.
Clearly, it's not a tone control, is it? 67. It's a gain control.
Yeah, that's a gain.
Therefore, implying that there was more gain in 1977 than there was in 67.
A lot more gain.
And this tone switch here is kind of removing some bass end if you flip it over to the other side, which we never like to do. But I guess in some environments you might.
Oh, the G string on a Les Paul.
They fixed that in 1973. So let me just find that for you.
There you go. That sounds good, man. That's a really nice sounding overdrive pedal. That's the sound, isn't it? Great.
Want to try the fuzz side?
Yes, fuzz
okay,
me up,
baby. Okay, so now fuzz, we've got an input control, an output control, and a haze control, which, given that the knobs are purple. Here we go.
Hold on, Les Paul.
We'll be right back.
man.
It does sound great.
What?
It's a lot less, I mean, it's not fuzz.
Less fuzzy
than... It's more, I would say, Big Muff fuzz than you know, Tone Bender fuzz or anything like that. Yeah. It's just a
Do you want to try another guitar here? Do you want to try
Yeah, give it a try with a single coil something or other.
Yeah, Strat.
Okay, Strat up, now. I'll just do the same too.
That's good.
I love the sparkle on the top end.
Yeah.
It's got that, sometimes with overdrive pedals, that, you know, it rolls off all that sort of treble end in it, which sounds nice and smooth. But I think
like a real amp would sound compared to a non-real amp, you know what I'm saying?
I like it. Okay.
You would think it would be,
I don't
right?
know why they've gone with this sort of haze reference to infer Hendrix, because it's not really giving me Hendrix vibes.
I'm afraid of the lesser.
Ladies and gentlemen, is the Fuzz Bubble 45. Prices, by the way, for all this stuff will be available on the Andertons website. I mean, I think all around about the sort of £200 or £300 mark, as are all these sort of, you know, little boutique American pedal companies these days.
You get a box with it and everything, you know.
next, let's just do this Alien Twister. Okay.
Sorry.
Now, this is when you need a real fuzz expert here, because I'm always aware of the fact that fuzz players sometimes are like, oh, you can't have the buffer because it messes up the fuzz, or you have to have the buffer because then you can't use other pedals with it, and blah, 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 blah. From what I understand of this Alien Twister, your buff or buffer is optional. You can turn it on or off. Other than that, we've basically just got, they describe it as a category F5 tornado of a fuzz pedal.
Have you watched the film Nope?
Nope.
Okay, well that's an Alien Twister kind of thing.
Okay. Let's try
it. You should watch it. It's a good film.
Let's see what it does without the buffer for them.
Yes, that's the stuff.
I'm not sure we're getting the full effect of having the buffer in or out because we're not using any other pedals. But yes, you can absolutely hear that a little bit of extra top end there when you put that in. So Stab, I'm guessing other brands perhaps might refer to this as a bias control or something. So you can go from very spitty kind of fuzz through to sort of warm fuzz.
Thank you.
come here with a Strat. We haven't heard a bad one yet.
Nope. It's a good start to the week.
It is a good start. Analog Alien, why have we not? I mean, I've heard of them, but I
haven't.
Yeah,
this is my first encounter with the. These don't fly
these
out the door, then I'll be surprised. We need a lot of money, but absolutely awesome.
Let's dial it back a little bit here. We'll just go for a compressor now. The Alien Comp. We've gone to a telecast.
Someone, if you're dialing back there,
It reminds me a little bit of that Paul Reed Smith compressor that we did recently, which was just very simple to dial in a nice tone. I like it.
It's very compressed, isn't it?
The ratio control, again, I think is the one where, you know, as a guitar player, you'll really sense that this compression effect. So all the way up, it's very squeezed in, you know.
It's time to keep the volume very straight.
If I turn it down, it's a more...
There's much more... I can control it.
Yeah.
If you turn it up...
Yeah.
Everything stays the same kind of level.
But for me...
Sorry.
For me, just as someone that would just want a simple pedal compressor on their board rather than some, you know, rack studio thing, that's all I would want.
Sounds great. Mine with jacks, though.
Joe Walsh got it right, didn't he? Joe Walsh was like, I need jack up on the top. And all the other ones on the side. So he's totally right.
No, that one over there isn't. And this is near the orange bar.
That's true. That's true.
But listen to that. So this is just... It just does that. It does that thing that you want for a compressor. You know, you put it on. And you never take it off.
We've only got two more to go, haven't we? Because like I said, we're not doing the bass one. So, the bucket seat. Now, Pete, tell people about the bucket tone. What's the bucket tone?
Well, bucket tone is...
2 very boring minutes later.
It makes sense.
That's it. You have to be there. And we have absolutely no idea if this pedal is about trying to get that bucket tone, but it's called the bucket seat.
Isn't the bucket seat
something in a sports car? Isn't that
like it is. We should make a pedal called the bucket tone. And
I
then
agree.
All it does is ooh.
Why don't we just make a bucket with just literally two inputs on either side?
We made the pedals first.
This is an overdrive pedal designed around the sound of a 69 Plexi, and there's nothing wrong with a 69 Plexi, right, Mr.
A 69
P?
Or a Plexi. It's great, man. I tell you why it sounds like that, because it's got top-mounted jacks on it.
Yeah,
status quo.
No. Listen. So the gain control on here, I've just read on the interweb here. Mm-hmm. If you turn the gain control all the way off, unlike a lot of distortion pedals where that will essentially mean there's no volume there, it is now just acting like a boost pedal. And then so you can just introduce ganache to taste, like adding, you know, your favorite...
yes, just go on.
Herb or spice to your favorite meal. Anyway, okay, so... So it's just a big...
That's nice, isn't
it? Here we go, and let's...
That's got the bright plexi stuff going on.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, the horribleness of the plexi.
That sort of...
That's where nobody ever goes. No.
That's interesting. So the more you turn the gain up, the more the treble seems to roll off and the more you want to compensate by putting the tone in. But this is a great range of pedals. I'm really like,
I want to try that with this less balls.
Why is this not more, famous?
Because there's so many pedals.
There's so many pedals
in
the world.
And unless that pedal show or us, or, you know, show them people the world these pedals, then...
Absolutely. We have a moral duty to show the world. We're going to make the world a better place.
And, you know, we don't pre-do anything. We just pluck them in and see if they're good or bad, and you get what you get.
Ridiculous, man. Okay, the last one. Actually, this is not intentionally, but I have saved the most expensive one till last. Or is it the most expensive?
I want to take a picture. Absolutely awesome.
Because despite the fact that this one doesn't leave you a lot of change out of £400, it's actually got three effects in it. This could be for guitar players the only pedal that you would need. Pete and I talked loads and loads of time. What do you really need? Drive, delay, reverb. Sometimes you don't even need reverb if your amp's got reverb in. But hey, this is the rumble seat.
That's just how I like.
And it's got top-mounted jacks. In fact, so did the bucket seat. That's why it sounds so good.
So you could essentially just use that pedal.
And yeah, you could just have an old tube amplifier with no reverb in it, no nothing. Just this straight in the front, boom. In fact, let's turn the reverb off your amp and we'll just use the reverb off here. So, let's just start with a little bit of reverb.
In the shape of a guitar.
Very clever.
That's good.
That's good.
It's springy, isn't it?
No, it's
like
springy.
Splashy. Yeah, it's got...
I know that sounded like, that's good. It sounded like I'm really surprised, but I'm always surprised when a digital reverb does the springiness.
Yeah.
Like it almost completely lost it.
There's a lot to go here. Look.
But it's got that ding 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 ding.
Yeah, I like it. It's even almost got that bit
that's
of
what I'm saying,
modulation.
Like, and I could hear that already before it was even turned up very loud.
Wow.
I thought this is the funniest thing he's ever heard. But I was surprised, because reverb, the
sound's good.
And it's got that little modulation that the springs
give
you.
I like it. Right.
Oh, shut up.
Let's go with a bit of tone and.
Holy smoke!
Quite a bit more gain in it than the
bucket
seat. You know what? You could go Joe Walsh into rumble seat, and then you'd have compression,
Joe Walsh on
a basic amp sound, drive, delay, and reverb.
Oh, you're looking at 700 to 800
quid.
Yeah,
I mean, it's a lot of money to do it that way, I suppose.
But hey, you've got plenty of money.
Yeah, I mean, if you've got a £5,000 Les Paul and a £2,000 valve amplifier, what's another 700 quid on pedals, right? If you can't afford to heat your home this year, then maybe not. Right, let's try some delay.
But this is hot enough. Yeah. So what have you got there?
Delay time, repeats, and mid.
So the time, so you can have a short one.
It's not massively long. So its longest setting is 650 milliseconds.
All the way.
That's enough, right?
Yeah.
And,
most people would want a slap back. Take the reverb off and you can hear it better.
So you go a bit shorter.
No, I would go a little bit longer.
Okay.
And then a bit feedback. Is that feedback? I was rolling it off the tone.
I didn't miss one out. Let's just quickly talk about this green one here. Alien Base Station. Wow, it's got a limiter, compressor, an amp generator, and a fuzz.
We'll get the guys to do that, right?
Holy moly, yeah. Three buttons in one. That sounds epic. And I'm kind of, I don't think I've ever seen anything quite as, pro-looking as this, in the sense of, I just thought it was like an AB box, but then it's got Actually, it's not even an AB box. Is it AB box?
Well, it's got an in and out. It's a DI box, so you can have, I don't know.
So hang on a second. It's an in, a balanced out with an effects loop on the A side and an effects loop on the B side. So, right, so it's not an AB box.
It could work for acoustic as well because it's got dual jack and
XLR. It's even got phono outs. I've never ever seen like a phono outputs on a guitar.
Man, it can do everything. That can make your coffee.
So yeah, it's not an AB box. I completely lied. It's like a looper DI boxy thing.
Awesome. Man, I love these pedals.
Yeah, me too.
Thumbs up for me.
I just want them for the little cooler bag that you get.
It's your lunchbox every morning.
Absolutely. Speaking of lunch. Right.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for tuning in.
Like, subscribe, and, you win some stuff.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll see you in the next video. Au revoir.